Today, we will create another simulation to practice real-time data connectivity and visualization using Power BI and SQL Server. We will create a query in SQL Server Management Studio to generate random data per second, which will be displayed in Power BI dashboard in real time. We will use the direct query method to connect Power BI to SQL Server. We will start our exercise by creating a database in SQL Server. We will call it Plant. Then we will create a table inside the Plant database. The first column we need is Time, which will record the current date and time. In the next column, we will monitor and store the voltage. A numeric data type with two decimal places will be better to store the voltage. Next, we will monitor and store the temperature. A typical plant monitoring system also monitors the pressures. Let's also create a column for machine load. Load is a reserved word, therefore it is placed in brackets. Finally, we will create a column for output. Let's save the table with the name of monitor. In the next step, we will create a SQL query to simulate a plant dashboard. Let's declare variables for each column, starting with the time column. We will use the same data types we used during table creation. GetDate function is used to get the current date and time. Similarly, we will declare variables for all other columns, with initial value being 0. Now we will create a loop for our simulation. 1 equal 1 means, the loop never ends on its own. On each iteration, we will wait for 1 second. Inside the loop, we will assign values to each field. The voltage field will show values between 1000 to 1100. 1000 is fixed, the remaining 100 will be random. Let's assign a random value to the temperature field, between 110 to 120. Let's create random load for our plant. We will also assign a random value for plant output. Finally, let's insert these values into our database, after each iteration. Let's execute the query to check the output. It seems that we forgot to insert a field. First, we will generate random data for the missing field, which is pressure. Then we will add this field to the insert command. Now we can execute the query again. We can use a select query to see if the data has been entered into the table or not. We ran our simulation query for about 6 seconds, during which it added 6 rows to our monitor table. Now we can connect this database to the Power BI desktop application, and create a plant monitor dashboard out of it. The voltage field is showing 0. Because we are generating value greater than 999, while we declared a numeric value of 5 values, 2 out of which are decimal places. Therefore, this field cannot store a value greater than 999. Let's delete the existing data. We must make changes to our query to generate voltage value less than 999. Now our query is generating the correct values. In the next chapter, we will connect this data to the Power BI desktop application. To connect to the SQL Server database, open the Get Data window and look for SQL Server database. Select the SQL Server database and press Connect. In the SQL Server database, select Direct Query if you want to update the dashboard in real time. From SQL Server Management Studio, get the name of the server and the table and enter them in their fields on the SQL Server database window. Now, press OK to connect to the SQL Server database in real time. From the Navigator window, we will select the monitor table and press Load. This will load the data into the Power BI desktop application. Now we can create a dashboard using these fields. We will start our dashboard by creating a title using the text box visual. Now, we will add a gauge chart to display voltage. We will add the voltage field to the value area. To show the latest single voltage, we will filter the time field by top 1. We will add the time field to the by value area, filtered by latest time. This will show the last voltage from monitor table, which we can confirm from SQL Server Management Studio. And as you can see, both values are the same. We will change the width of the gauge visual to 256 to fit 5 of them in one row. We will create a measure to show minimum value in the voltage visual. And another measure to show the maximum voltage. We will create a copy of the gauge visual to show the temperature. We will replace the voltage field with the temperature field. Let's confirm the temperature value from SQL database. Let's create two measures to show the minimum and maximum temperatures. Let's replace the existing fields with the new measures we created. We will use the copy of existing gauge visual to create a visual for pressure. Let's replace the temperature field with the pressure field. We will create new measures to display minimum and maximum values. Let's place these measures into the minimum and maximum areas of the gauge chart. Let's create a copy of the gauge chart to display the load. We will replace the pressure field with the load field. Finally, we will create a copy of the gauge chart to display the output. Let's create a line and column chart to display the load and the output values over time. We will add the time field to the x-axis, the output field to the column y-axis. And the load field to the line y-axis. We will add the time field to the filters to display latest 40 values only by selecting top 40 and the latest time in the filters settings. Our dashboard is now ready. Let's run the simulation in SQL Server Management Studio and see the results in Power BI. We also need to turn on the page refresh option in the page format settings. We need to set the page refresh interval to 1 second. Let's delete the previous data and execute the simulation query again. Now, everything is working as it should. Our dashboard is showing real-time information from SQL Server. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.